Hey everybody, it's me, Kai Man, and you are in for a treat. Today we're going to talk a little bit about astrology, my favorite subject. I've been delving a bit into astrology for a while now. I've got some books here with me that I'm going to kind of just tell you guys real quickly the names of the books, and I'll have them down in the comment section. So if you guys would like to get some information to research, I'll give you the names of the books. The first one is The Secret Language of Astrology, and this one is by Roy Gilette. And the next one is The Only Astrology Book You'll Ever Need, and this is by Joanna Martin Wolfolk. And I have another book, and it's called The Beginner's Guide to Astrology. This is like a workbook, so that's really good. And then I have this other book that I just recently purchased, and it's called The Astrology of You and Me, How to Understand and Improve Every Relationship in Your Life. This is a great book to have. So if you know the sun sign of any of your friends, your coworkers, your boss, it gives you different scenarios, different situations, and your role within their lives and how to treat them, how to approach them, even to how to take them on a date if you need. This is a good book, so get this one as well. This is another book that I have that's called Signs and Symbols Source Book, and it's not an astrology book. This is something that I picked up, but I use this because I don't know if you can see here, it talks about all the different signs and symbols. And so it gives a little bit about astrology as well. That's in here, the symbols and how they correlate to the sign. It also gives you some other things too. What I really love about this book is because it tells you why certain hoods are wearing, where it's a pointed hood or it's a top hat, or the gloves that are worn, why they're worn and what they represent. So even Ku Klux Klan, all that stuff, it talks about all different types of symbols and why we wear those particular symbols. And also for like some major companies, like the logos that they have, it kind of breaks down those logos as well, and you can look at it and you can see all those things that were hidden. So this is something good for those who are into occult things, where you're able to look underneath something, those things that are hidden, and actually look at them and say, okay, I know what that means, and whether or not you need to enter or not, you know. So this is a great book as well. But again, I've been studying astrology for quite some time now. I've really been in astrology probably most of my life, but not in the way that I have really been recently, like really delving into it. But I remember being young and being told, not by my mother, because I don't believe that she really, you know, cared, because I think she knew that I was a good kid. But I remember growing up and hearing some people who were really into church say that you shouldn't read the horoscopes. You shouldn't, you know, try and study your sign, astrology, all that. It was demonic. It was of the devil and whatever. But if that were so, when you think about the story of the three wise men and how they found Jesus, they were looking up at the stars in order to find where he is. And so he was, rather. It's the same thing with us. You know, we need to look to the stars and how the planets were aligned at the time that we're born, because it does affect us. Everything that's around you affects you. So, you know, having that information kind of gives you like the one up on everything in life. It kind of tells you, you know, not only, you know, about your characteristics and things of that nature, but it also is like a blueprint. So when we talk about astrology, what we're talking about is the stars and the celestial bodies and how it influences human affairs, whether that be individuals, groups, a society, a collective, as well as the environment around us. And so being able to study those things, and when we say human affairs, we're talking about our personalities, our moods, and our characteristics and things of that nature. So I have really been not only just studying who I am, you know, my sign and my chart, but I've also been really studying the planets, the houses, as well as the different signs, and really understanding that for each sign that we have, they kind of represent, if you're thinking about the 12 signs, they represent the 12 disciples. So each one of those 12 signs is combined to make a whole, to make one, the whole universe and what it is that, you know, we are and how we operate, you know, as a collective. And so each one of those signs are needed, you know, whether it's, you know, the Aquarius who are the water bearers, the humanitarians of society, whether it is Scorpios who are the people who are into the transformation that help you transform and transition and help you go through that death and rebirth cycles in life. That's what we are purposed to do. And if you don't really understand your sign and who, you know, you come into being, then it's hard for you to kind of navigate this world. And it doesn't make sense for you not to know who you are, because when you really think about it, being more self-aware helps you to win faster, helps you to win quicker. You know, otherwise, if you just, you know, want to try to figure everything out and you have a hard time, that, you know, that's on you. But if you want to really know who you are and how you operate and which situations or circumstances are best to be in and to make the best decisions, then astrology is your thing. Get into your birth chart or your natal chart and figure out where your signs are, where your planets are in each one of the signs, and kind of go through that. And we're going to do that this couple of weeks. I'm going to talk to you guys about it in detail. I'm going to take things and break it down really slow, and I'm going to teach you how I learn it, you know. And again, I believe it is important. The more you know about yourself, the quicker, the faster that you can win and be, you know, successful in your life, whatever that success means for you, whether it's, you know, actually becoming an entrepreneur, whether it's, you know, getting that job that you want, or whether it's just being able to live a life of spirituality in whatever level of spirituality that you want, whatever. It helps you to understand those things and why you gravitate towards those things. So, again, if we were to talk about astrology, again, it is the study of the stars and the celestial bodies and how those things influence us, our personalities, our moods, and things of that nature. I've been in dealing with astrology for quite some time. And when I really started understanding, like getting my natal chart and taking a look at it and really studying myself, I come to realize why I am the way that I am, why I like to delve into those occult things, those things that are metaphysical, spirituality and different types of spirituality, why I don't just gravitate towards one thing, and how I kind of, you know, look at a bunch of different things and kind of combine them to whatever works for me. And that's because of who I am, the day that I was born, the time that I was born, and the place that I was born is what is all determines who I was at that particular moment and who I was going to be. So if you want to know really what your purpose is, you really need to be studying yourself. You need to be studying your sign, your astrology, your natal or birth chart, whichever one. I say both of them because some people say natal chart, some people say birth chart. So you'll hear me say natal or birth chart. So either one of them. But make sure that you guys, you know, go to, I'll put down in the comments some different websites so that you can look up your natal chart and your birth chart. If you don't understand it, we're gonna talk about this every Saturday at 12 p.m. I'm gonna do a new video and kind of tell you how to look at your natal chart, what you're looking for. I'm telling you, I'm going to do it the easy way because I've been studying different people and had to really, and I've gotten books and I've kind of had to realize what was the easiest way for me to remember this and how it would help me. And so I'm going to use those hints and those shortcuts with you guys. So thank you for listening and thank you for tuning in. Like I said, every Saturday at noon, there will be a new video, new astrology video. Okay, so we're going to talk about these things. Peace out. Love you guys. Enjoy. Make sure that you guys subscribe to the channel as well as hit that little button at the top. That way so you can get notified every time that I publish a new video. Don't be shy. I'm not really looking at who's, you know, doing what. I'm just trying to be a help. I'm just trying to, you know, show people different things that they can do to understand more about themselves and to become more self-aware. I'm not really trying to say, oh, such and such light. That's not what this is about. So enjoy. If you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And don't forget, in the comment section, I'll have these books. Peace out, people. Deuces. Yeah.
I want you to show me how to get to know someone like you, someone like you.